Football weather has finally arrived. We have a couple of big college games. Obviously, our Circle City Classic going on here at Lucas Oil, but we also have Ball State home game, Iowa home game, Purdue homecoming.
All
it's going to be a busy day today, throughout Central Indiana. We're talking temperatures, and let's take you back the past 10 days. So, in case you forgot, this is a good refresher. We've been well above average most of the latter part of September, middle part as well. So we'll go back to the 13th of the month when we had a high of 84. And ever since then, it's been well above average. We've had nearly 40, 90 plus degree days so far this year. We normally have around 15. So we've been significantly warmer than average for this summertime season. And now today we're wrapping that up, starting fall, and of course, Mother Nature working in our favor, also going to bring in this cooler air. Now, not only have we been impacted by this cold front, we're going to be underneath this cloud deck for most of the day today, and that will hinder much of a warming trend. So now we're falling into the 50s. We're only going to rebound into the 60s this afternoon. Let's take you up to Muncie, where Ball State will host Western Kentucky. I didn't know if you know this, but there's a little bit of a rivalry. A lot of Ball State grads work here at WTHR. We also have our own Sean Ash, who went to Western Kentucky. So there's been a little Twitter battle going on here. A lot on the line here as we watch this game this afternoon. Kickoff is at 3 o'clock, and temperatures will hold steady through the mid-60s with the mostly cloudy sky. Going to be a dry one up at Ball State. Should be a dry one as well down at IU in Bloomington. Now, there are a few stray showers possible across the southern part of the state, but that's mainly going to be this afternoon. By the time we get into 7 o'clock, tailgate looks good, just cloudy. By 7:30 at kickoff, we'll be at 65 degrees down in Bloomington and keeping a mostly cloudy sky around as that game gets underway and eventually wraps up later this evening. Again, Future Track 13 keeps at least a chance of a stray sprinkle around from Bedford to Seymour down through Mitchell. That's through the early afternoon. By 4 o'clock, that front's going to continue to push off to the south, so that will take our rain chances away with us. By 7:30, you'll notice a clearing from north to south, and that will continue through the overnight with a mostly clear sky. And that will, of course, contribute to a very chilly overnight. A lot of us in the 40s as we start out. We're Sunday, around 48 degrees in Greencastle, 51 here at Indianapolis. Stays just a bit warmer in the city because we have a lot more concrete, a lot of different objects, buildings, things like that to retain the heat. So it doesn't get as cool in the city, but you get out in rural locations and it's going to be a lot cooler. Chilly, in fact, over to Richmond, 47 to get your Sunday started. We keep a mostly clear sky around 4 tomorrow. Nearly a picture perfect fall day with highs back in the mid-70s, very seasonal for this time of year, and then the rain returns on Monday. Clouds first build in through the overnight, and then widespread rain for your Monday afternoon. So enjoy your Sunday. Certainly going to be the pick of the weekend with all that extra sunshine and temperatures that will be a little warmer, 67 by noon, back up to 75 by 5 p.m. Now, it's a stormy start to next week. We'll pick this up at 7 a.m. on Monday. Notice these showers continue to push in. Here's Tuesday morning at 7 a.m., showers and thunderstorms will be a possibility before we can get this front to come through. Looks like we'll keep a chance of rain around all the way from Monday morning through Wednesday morning, then some drier weather come midweek. So we'll go 66 today. We're back up to 75 tomorrow, a seasonal 76 on Monday and Tuesday before we cool back off behind that front, Alyssa, next week. Mid-70s, but look to stay mainly dry through next Friday.